this a delightful place or what?
Oh yeah, it's quite wonderful.
Here, we'll discover the factors that cause our raindrop to slow its downward progress and create features like this wonderful lake.
In Learning Circle 2, we saw how individual raindrops combine together, emerge from the ground as tiny springs, and move downhill through the force of gravity.
We also saw evidence of two parts of the water cycle at work: percolation,
where water moves through the ground under our feet,
and transpiration,
where our raindrop is pulled up through plants and evaporates from their leaves and needles into the atmosphere as a gas.
We also talked about the differences between deciduous trees, whose leaves fall off in the fall and come back in the spring,
and evergreen trees, whose leaves stay on year-round.
We learned that deciduous trees help evergreens and a variety of other plants and animals thrive and sustain in their ecosystem, this watershed.
Okay, hang on. New term, Ava. Explain ecosystem for us.
I would love to. This is one of my favorite subjects. An ecosystem is a geographic area where plants, animals, and other organisms, as well as weather and landscape, work together to form a bubble of life, containing biotic, or living parts, as well as abiotic, or non-living parts.
Ecosystems are like interconnected webs. We all depend on them, and contribute to their balance or imbalance by the way we act as one of their parts.
And make no mistake, there is no such thing as human existence separate from nature. We are as much a part of nature here as the trees or the salmon.
Absolutely. We are not just visitors here. We are a part of the web. We all play an important part in the ecosystems where we live. It's like we're related to nature. We're a part of it, and it's a part of us.
All the more reason to take care of everything that lives within your ecosystem.
This is where the constant downward force of gravity brings our raindrop together with millions of others.
Just think about how many raindrops it took to form this lake.
Lots of factors can cause features like lakes to form. It all has to do with something that slows the force of gravity, which then slows our raindrop, which causes it to collect into a larger body before it can continue on its gravitational path.
What factors do you think formed this one?
Let us investigate further. This lake was formed by the hard work of one of Earth's best natural engineers and builders, the mighty beaver.
Years ago, a beaver came to a small creek where this lake is now and built a dam out of sticks and mud, slowing our raindrop's progress down the watershed. Soon, the water backed up behind the dam and formed this lake.
Animals like beavers change their ecosystem to make the habitat they need to provide food and shelter, and to hide from predators like coyotes, bobcats, and bears.
Beaver dams are not only a benefit to beavers, they can also help this entire ecosystem by providing habitat for lots of other animals.
So whether you're a beaver or a human, anytime a living creature makes a change in its natural world, these changes can affect the biotic and abiotic factors of the entire ecosystem that surrounds them.
Here at Westwind, some secret infrared cameras were set up near the lake so we could see how many animals came to its waters.
Each of these animals was drawn here because of the changes our busy beaver made to the landscape.
Remember we mentioned that ecosystems are like big webs? It's all a matter of balance. When you disturb one part of the web, it has some sort of effect on all its other parts.
You got it. Hey, I think we hear our raindrop escaping somewhere over there from Lost Lake. Should we go check it out?
I think I hear it too. Follow me!